हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर अवनीश गोयल, अ सीनियर कंसल्टेंट डर्मेटोलॉजिस्ट एंड एस्थेटिक लेजर सर्जन। आई हैव पोस्ट एमडी क्लिनिकल एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ ओवर 15 इयर्स। आई एम एजुकेटर एंड ओरेटर इन डर्मेटोलॉजी, सेक्सुअली ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीजेस, लेजर्स एंड एस्थेटिक प्रोसीजर्स। आई हैव मोर देन 25 पब्लिकेशंस इन माई नेम। आई हैव वास्ट क्लिनिकल एक्सपीरियंस। आई एम ऑल्सो ए फिटनेस फ्रीक एंड मैराथन रनर। आई हैव अ टेलीग्राम ग्रुप बाय द नेम डर्मेटोलॉजी बाय डॉक्टर अवनीश। द लिंक टू दैट ग्रुप इज डर्मेटोलॉजी _for_NEETPG. So let us crack NEETPG with India's largest learning platform, that is Unacademy, wherein you will have daily live classes, you will have live tests and quizzes, you will have structured course and unlimited access to the live and recorded courses. So these are the subscription rate. 1 month subscription is around 4,500 rupees, and if you use the code Dr. Avnish -YT, you will get additional 10% of discount. So let us start with the 40 important signs of dermatology, and the first sign to discuss is the antenna sign. So antenna sign, it is seen in patients with keratosis pilaris, in which the individual hair follicle along with the hair shaft will have a long strand of keratin protruding through it. So you will have a hair shaft and along with it a long strand of keratin protruding through the hair follicle, and it is best seen when the light is directly tangentially over the lesions. The next sign is the bulla spread sign, also called as Lute sign. It refers to the extension of bulla. So it refers to the extension of blister over the unblistered skin when the unidirectional pressure, remember the word unidirectional means the pressure is applied from one direction in bulla spread sign. However, in the Esbo-Hansen sign, which is seen in small, intact or tense blister, here the pressure is applied at the top of the blister. So the bulla spread sign can be seen in pemphigus vulgaris as well as bullous pemphigoid. However, the extension in pemphigus vulgaris will be the irregular and angulated, and in bullous pemphigoid, along with various subepidermal blistering diseases, the extension of blister will be round and regular. Then the third sign is Auspitz sign, which is characteristic of psoriasis, in which you will appreciate pinpoint bleeding on removal of scales of a psoriatic plaque. So to elicit the Auspitz sign, the test you do is a Garretta's test. So with a glass slide, you scrape the lesions of psoriasis. So the scraping of the lesion of psoriasis with the glass slide, it is called as Garretta's test. And on doing the Garretta's test, you will elicit a Auspitz sign. So Auspitz sign is pinpoint bleeding, which is elicited on removal of scales over the psoriatic plaques. So it is a feature of psoriasis. It can be a feature of Darius disease and actinic keratosis. Third sign is the Buschke-Ollendorff sign. So it is seen in secondary syphilis along with the cutaneous vasculitis. It is the presence of deep dermal tenderness. So deep dermal tenderness, which is elicited on pressing the papular lesions of secondary syphilis or cutaneous vasculitis with a pinhead, it is called as positive Buschke-Ollendorff sign. Then the next sign is breakfast, lunch and dinner sign. It is seen due to the bites of bed bugs, and it follows a linear pathway which is in a group of 3 to 5 blood meals, and it is often referred to as breakfast, lunch or dinner sign, or breakfast, lunch and supper sign. So this is the three blood meal of the bed bug, the breakfast, lunch and dinner of the bed bug, which is in a line. So this is called as breakfast, lunch and dinner sign. Next is the buttonhole sign, which is a feature of neurofibromatosis on von Recklinghausen's disease. So in von Recklinghausen's disease, the lesions of neurofibromatosis, they can be pressed inside towards the subcutaneous tissue and they will reappear back on release of pressure. So this is the lesions can be invaginated with the tip of index finger into the subcutaneous tissue, and they will reappear back on release of pressure. So this is a feature of neurofibromatosis. Along with neurofibromatosis, the buttonhole sign can be seen in the patients of anatoderma and dermatofibromas. The fourth sign is the Karpeteks sign, which is a feature of discoid lupus erythematosus. So in discoid lupus erythematosus, you will get follicular dilatation and plugging and adherent scaling. So these are hair follicles which will be dilated, and you will get adherent plugging. So these plugs, they will occupy that dilated hair follicle. So when you remove these plugs, so this is called as carpetaxime. The appearance of these plugs, it is called as carpetaxime. So when scales are removed, the under surface of the scales may show the horny plugs which occupy the hair follicle. So it is called as carpetaxime, tinctaxime or cat tongue sign. So apart from discoid lupus erythematosus, it can be seen in the patients of seborrheic dermatitis. Next sign is the caudability sign, which was discovered by Schuster, and it is seen in the patients of alopecia areata. So what happens in the patients of alopecia areata? If a pressure is applied on the hair shaft, mainly in the peripheral lesion of the alopecia areata, if a vertical pressure is applied over the hair shaft, due to the thinning of the proximal hair shaft, the hair tends to bend. So the proximal thinner hair shaft tend to bend when pushed inside towards the scalp. It is called as positive caudability sign. It is due to weakening of hair shaft. Apart from alopecia areata, the positive caudability sign, it can be a feature of radiation induced dermatitis or radiation induced alopecia. Next is the Crouche sign. So Crouche sign is the axillary freckling in patients of neurofibromatosis 1, and it is called as positive Crouche sign. The deck chair sign. So deck chair sign was classically described for a condition called as papilloerythroderma of effugi. So herein, the flat top red lesions of the papilloerythroderma of effugi, they become generalized, but they spare the abdominal skin fold. So there will be erythroderma, but the sparing of the abdominal skin fold will be there. So it is a characteristic feature of papilloerythroderma of effugi. However, it can be seen in drug-induced erythroderma, in mycosis fungoides, and in patients of Lepromatous leprosy. Next is Derrière sign, which is veeling induced by stroking the skin in a patient of urticaria pigmentosa. So in urticaria pigmentosa, you will get hyperpigmented lesions. If you stroke the lesions, due to release of histamine from the mast cells, so there will be a veeling over the lesion, and it is seen in urticaria pigmentosa. Apart from it, it can be seen in leukemia cutis, in juvenile xanthogranuloma, and Langerhans cells histiocytosis. The pseudo-derrière sign, it is a feature of congenital smooth muscle hematoma or Becker's nevus, in which the stroking of the skin or the lesions, it produces the induration and pyloerection, and it will in turn lead to a feeling of swelling. The dimple sign or Fitzpatrick sign, it is a feature of dermatofibroma. On application of lateral pressure with the thumb and index finger, it results in the formation of a depression. So if you try to displace the lesion of dermatofibroma by applying a lateral pressure, there will be formation of a dimple. So this is called as dimple sign or Fitzpatrick sign. Next is the Doryflop sign, which is a feature of primary syphilis or syphilitic chancre. That is, on retraction of the skin of prepuce, the entire ulcer flips out. But it is quite difficult to slip it inside because of the induration of the ulcer. So this is the Doryflop sign, which is a feature of primary syphilis. The next sign is the Flex sign. So Flex sign, it is seen over the hair, it is seen over the nail. So it is alternating band of normal pigmentation and hypopigmentation. So the normal pigmentation, it corresponds to the episode of normal nutrition, and hypopigmentation, it corresponds to the episode of intermittent malnutrition. So you will get alternate pigmented and hypopigmented zone over the hair, over the nails, and it can be a feature of kwashiorkor. The Forshimer sign, which is seen in rubella patients, it is an enanthem in the oral cavity. It is characterized by the dull red macules or PTK over the soft palate during the prodromal phase or the first day of the rash. Apart from rubella patients, it can be seen in patients of infectious mononucleosis. The Friar-Tuck sign. The Friar-Tuck, he was a companion of Robin Hood in the legendary story. So this guy, he had alopecia over the scalp, but sparing the hair in the occipital region. So the Friar-Tuck sign goes by his name. It is a feature, it is a scene in trichotillomania, in which patient plucks out his own hair in It can be in two ways, either in a wave-like pattern across the scalp, or it can be centrifugal plucking out of hair, which will start from a single starting point. So there can be a band-like pattern across the scalp, or there can be a centrifugal pattern of hair loss over the vertex, and it can be seen, it is called as the phryataxian. However, the hair over the occipital area, they are spared. The Gottron sign, it is a feature of dermatomyositis. It is characterized by the scaly erythematous eruption over dorsal of hand, over the metacarpophalangeal joints, over the interphalangeal joints, and it is a photosensitive rash. Next sign is the groove sign of Greenblatt, which is a feature of lymphogranuloma venerum. So in lymphogranuloma venerum, there is swelling of the inguinal group of lymph nodes. There is a swelling of the femoral group of the lymph nodes. So the inguinal ligament or the Popart ligament, it acts as a groove between the swelling of inguinal and femoral group of lymph nodes. And this is called as positive groove sign of Greenblatt, and it is seen in lymphogranuloma venerum. The hanging curtain sign, it is a feature of pityriasis rosea. So when the lesions of pityriasis rosea, they are stretched along the axis of herald patch. So the scales are seen, which are noted to be finer, lighter, attached at one end, and tend to fold across the line of stretch. So the scaling will be attached at one side. They will be finer, lighter, and they tend to fold along the line of stretch. So this is hanging curtain sign, and it is seen in pityriasis rosea. The Hertogis sign or Queen's Anise sign, it is characterized by the loss of lateral one-third of the eyebrows. So it can be positive in many conditions, namely leprosy, mixed edema, follicular mucinosis, atopic dermatitis, trichotillomania, ectodermal dysplasia, discoid lupus erythematosus, alopecia areata, syphilis, systemic sclerosis, HIV infection, and hypothyroidism. So there will be loss of lateral one-third of the eyebrows. The Hugominakis sign, it refers to the enlargement of the sternoclavicular end of the clavicle, usually the right side, and it is a manifestation of late congenital syphilis. The Holster sign, it is again a feature of dermatomyositis, and it is characterized by the confluent macular violaceous erythema over the hip and thighs, where the holster is worn, the revolver holster is worn, and it is a feature of dermatomyositis. The Hutchison sign. So Hutchison sign, it can be seen in subungual melanoma. It is characterized by melanonychia with pigmentation of the proximal nail fold. So it is a feature of or an indicator of subungual melanoma. Then another Hutchison sign, which is characterized by the papillovesicular eruptions, over the tip of the nose. It indicates the involvement of the cornea, because both of them, they are supplied by the nasociliary branch, a branch of the trigeminal nerve, and it is seen in herpes zoster. The third type of Hutchison sign or the micro Hutchison sign, it refers to the periungual pigmentation. So the pigmentation of periungual tissue, which usually cannot be seen with the naked eyes, but it can be visualized with the help of a dermatoscope, and it is a feature of early nail apparatus melanoma. Then the hypopyon sign. So hypopyon sign, so it is a feature of pyoderma, secondary infected vesico pustular disorders, so in which a transverse fluid level is seen. So when the patient stands, a transverse fluid level is seen with the purulent material over the base. So the transverse fluid level with comprising of purulent material over the bottom is seen when the patient stands, and it is called as positive hypopyon sign. It can be seen in bulla sympatico and secondarily infected vesico bullous disorders. The Ingram sign. So Ingram sign, it is inability to retract the lower eyelids in patients of progressive systemic sclerosis, and this is due to sclerosis over the underlying skin. The Lesser Trillet sign, it is the sudden development of multiple seborrheic keratosis. So usually the development of multiple seborrheic keratosis associated with pruritus, it is a marker of internal malignancies, mainly the adenocarcinoma of stomach and colon, and also squamous cell carcinoma, lymphomas and leukemias. The millions year sign. So this sign, it distinguishes erysipelas from cellulitis because the ear, it is ear involvement, it is a feature of erysipelas. So involvement of the ear, it is a feature of erysipelas because the erysipelas is an infection of superficial dermis and the upper part of the subcutaneous tissue. While the ear pinna will not be involved in cellulitis, because cellulitis, it is the involvement of deep subcutaneous tissue, and the ear pinna, it is devoid of the deep subcutaneous tissue. So the sparing of ear pinna in cellulitis, it is called as Millions ear sign. So no deeper dermal tissue and subcutaneous fat in ear pinna. It is a feature which is seen in Millions ear sign. So the cellulitis in facial infections does not involve the ear pinna, and it is called as positive Millions ear sign. The Nikolsky sign, it is the separation of epidermal layer from the underlying dermis by application of lateral pressure on normal appearing skin. So the Nikolsky sign, it is elicited on normal appearing skin. The pathology, it is due to development of antibodies to desmoglins of desmosomes, and it can be a feature of pemphigus group of disorders, staphylococcal scalded skin syndrome and epidermolysis bullosa. The volcano sign, it is a feature of old world cutaneous leishmaniasis. So the lesions of old world cutaneous leishmaniasis, they starts as a papule which undergoes central necrosis. So which undergoes central necrosis or ulceration, the border of the ulcer will have a erythematous rim, and it is called as volcano sign. So volcano sign, it is a feature of old world cutaneous leishmaniasis. Next sign is the Scholl sign. It is the development of confluent macular violaceous erythema over the posterior neck, over the shoulder, at the sites where the Scholl is worn, and it is a feature of dermatomyositis. Next sign is the Pupten sign, which is a feature of nail lichen planus. So the involvement of nail bed in the lichen planus, it elevates the nail gets split and the it and the split and elevated longitudinally, and the it is projected downwards towards the lateral nail edge. So this is the Pupten sign due to the development of lichen planus over the nail bed. The scratch sign, it is a feature of pitriasis versicolor. So barely perceptible scales of pitriasis versicolor, they stand out on stroking the skin with the fingernail. So this is the scratch sign or Cope de Jongel sign. The Schuster sign, it is the scarring over the concha of ear in discoid lupus erythematosus. So it is seen in 30% of the cases of DLE. So there will be scarring over the concha of ear in Schuster sign. Next sign is Wimberger sign, which is a manifestation of early congenital syphilis. So herein there will be bilateral symmetrical well-defined metaphyseal defect over the medial side of upper tibia. So there will be defect over the medial side of upper tibia, and it will result in pseudoparalysis. So this is Wimberger sign, and it is seen in early congenital syphilis. Now coming to the three signs which are by the name of Indian dermatologists. The first, the Pavitran nose sign. So Pavitran nose sign, it is a feature of exfoliative dermatitis. There is a complete absence of erythema and scaling over the nose and perinasal area. So in patients of erythroderma or exfoliative dermatitis, there will be generalized involvement of the body, but the nose and perinasal area, they will be spared. So this is Pavitran nose sign. The second sign by Indian dermatologist is Patrick Yesudian sign, which is characterized by the palmar melanotic macules, and it is seen in patients with neurofibromatosis 1. The third sign by Indian dermatologist, it is the Premlata sign, which is characterized by cerebriform tongue or the tongue showing the typical sulci and gyri, and it is seen over the dorsa of tongue, and it is a characteristic feature of Pemphigus vegetans, which is a variant of Pemphigus vulgaris. So I urge you to attend free live classes, plus courses and batches on Unacademy platform. Use my referral code Dr. Avnish-YT to get additional 10% discount. You can also subscribe to the Unacademy Live Neet PG on YouTube and Unacademy Neet PG Live on Telegram. So my classes on YouTube in the month of June, I have completed AIIMS June 2020 Dermatology Review. I have completed JIPMER 2019, 2018, 2017 Dermatology Review, and I am upcoming in next few days with multiple choice question quiz of STDs and leprosy. About the free classes in the month of June on Unacademy, I have completed previous year's recall MCQs of AIIMS. I have completed previous year's recall MCQs of JIPMER, and I am upcoming with previous year recall MCQs of FMGE in next few days. I also urge you to like, to share, to comment, and to subscribe to this YouTube channel. You can also press the bell icon to get the future notification. And thank you very much for your patient listening. Thank you.